Now, if you're like me, you do your coin roll hunting, and then if you recognize the error, then you put it in the flip, or you put it into a bag, or you put it into a roll for that specific type of coin. But when you first start doing, learning about penny roll hunting specifically, because that's what we're talking about here, is pennies. When you first start doing it, you're not going to really know what you're looking at. I didn't even know what a misaligned die was. I used to call them all off-centered until someone said that's not off-centered. And I had to, anyway, you know what I'm saying. It takes years and years and years, or hours and hours and hours, hundreds of hours of doing this on a regular basis to learn about, and I'm just talking about pennies. Like a real mishmashish might know about all types of coins. Me, I only focus on pennies because that's all my little brain can tolerate. And many months ago, I was just throwing, if I saw something interesting, I just threw it in a bag. And this is the bag. This bag, excuse me, I got water here. I don't drink coffee anymore. That's not true. I drink decaf. I just don't drink caffeinated coffee. And this is how many pennies we got. I mean, it's got to be like a roll or two. Let me see. It's a lot. So now every single one of these pennies in the past, I said there was something interesting on, weird, and I was going to look at it later. Guess what today's date is? Today is later date. That's it. All right, so let's get these nickels out of the way. Either there's something or they're nothing. Most likely nothing. 97p. Oh, it's because of the, it has a sandblasted look on it. I've seen this error before, or I've seen people talk about the state of this condition. But I don't think it's valuable. Okay, so anyway, today is D-Day. Either these are going to go back to the bank. Okay, this is a misaligned die. All right, so what we're going to do is, this might be a really long video because each one of these has something weird on it, and I'm going to look it up. And my buddy and member, Eric, keeneEyeCollectables, his YouTube channel is in the description below. He said he likes when I do the... what's it called? The research. So I want to see what a misaligned die of. And you know what I'm doing? I'm going to do only sold. I'm not even going to do selling for. I don't have time for it today. Either something selling for something, sold for something, like has a real value. And I'm going to do lowest first. And then we're going to put the year of the nickel. And now that it's up on the screen, all I have to do is, right, like I'm in. This is how research works on eBay. 1999 D nickel. Okay. This is how it works on eBay. I'm just going to put, take away the D. I'm going to put, maybe that was too much, too overboard. Okay. I'm going to take away the 1999. There's no 1999 misaligned that sold. All right. Now we have, and I'm going to do buy it now. I'm not too hot for the auctions because you could really get ripped on auctions. All right. So now we have it. And anything, one of two things is going to happen today. The coin is going in a flip, or the coin is going into a jar that's going back to the bank. That's it. I'm not messing around with these anymore. They got to go goodbye. So, What does a misaligned die sell for? Of a nickel. It's a 1990 D. Sells for about a buck. This one here is a better one. And that one. So let's see. So that might be, it's between $2 and $5. Oh yeah. So this one's pretty good. So it's actually probably worth $2 to $5. So what am I gonna do with it? So this goes into a flip. All right, that's it. Left, flip, right, bank. That's it. That's where we're at. And I'll show you what they're selling for. Oh, it's the 92. First of all, I probably didn't even look for the close A. Is it close AM? Oh, look at this. Is that bananas? That's hilarious. That the little mark is right there on the AM. I'm going to have to say it's still a wide AM. The 92, you're looking for the close AM. Look at all the cool damage. So that's what I'm saying. I saw that, first of all, back then I didn't even know about the close AM. I'll tell you that right now. So this is going back to the bank. That's it. Snap decisions. Now, what someone's going to do is say, hey, Jess, that penny's worth $5. Well, I don't care at this point. That's it. It has to come off the desk. 1991. And I have to keep my, what's that called up? So there's two things I have to juggle here. And that's the matte image and the eBay selling. All right. So 1991. It's not a special anything. I got to get a little closer, I think. It's probably that little halo thing. So again, now you might see something and go, Jess, oh, that's why the grease strike through. It's not good enough. That's it. Okay. It's on both sides. So I also have to separate the copper from the zinc. So there's three. So there's actually another step to this whole process. So I was going to say stupid process. It's not stupid. All right. So we have copper now. All right, this is zinc, 2006. Nope. That's it. 65. And I already know what I'm looking for when I look at it, because I'll know why I put it there as soon as I see it. Let me see. I mean, I would have to clean it, you know. Just for the R, I don't know. Let me see. I have to look. This is why its video is going to take a while. All right, so we got a 65 penny. I think it's a die error. That's what I'm going to put as die error. Only four came up. And they're in super duper condition. Oh, wow. Look at that. Look at this double struck mint. So dope. What is that, quarter? Oh, that's a penny. That's nice. All right. All right. I'll put this in a flip. Let's look at it closer. Let me look at it under the loop real quick. Oh, no, I don't like it under the loop. Nah, man, it looks like post-mint damage. Goodbye. All right, there we go. All right, so that's going to be the final look. It's going to be the loop look. 94. And I got to keep on clicking back on the, you know what? I wonder if there's a quicker, a better way to do this. I wonder if I could split the screen up. So that way I don't have to, All right. I think that'll work. So I split the screen up. I'll show you because I know you're just dying to see it, right? All right, here. All right, now the screen is split up so I can look stuff up and I don't have to keep on double clicking. All right, we got this 94, which if there's any doubling on the reverse. Yeah. So probably when I did this bag, it might even be before Eric from keeneEyeCollectables. He's been a big help. So is Otis. Here's a misaligned die. I don't know, 1990. And all of our members have been very helpful. Okay, I see why. Sandra, Shelia. Now, I have to admit, and even Donald, you know, you, Donald, if you're listening, you've been very helpful. Thank you. You know, just your support and contribution is greatly appreciated. You don't have to, you know, be a coin brain or anything like Eric is. Eric's a coin brain. And so is Otis, another one. See, so this looks like, you know, it's a strike. I'm not keeping it. It's too weak. I'm not keeping anything weak. I'm not putting anything weak into a flip. 81. No. That's it. I'm telling you, this video will take like 1,000 years to do if I don't. Yeah, so all these pennies probably went into see this, I'm just gonna throw some garbage. That's it. Goodbye. I'm telling you, I'm done with it. 61. Before Eric was a member, this is a bronze coin. And you know, so oh, what's that? Shoot. Now, I've seen them with the lines in there before, but the reason why this is intriguing me is because of this one little one right there. That is making me think it's restruck. That one little mark. All the rest of them, I'm not sure about. All right, so I have to, Well, Eric, you're going to be in your glory today because you said you like when I do research. Hey, is this the same penny? Oh, yeah, there it goes. Almost looks like a knight. I'm going to put it there. So what I'm going to do, see, now I actually have to open up. I'm going to open up another page. Okay, coin. Rim has lines through it and see what comes up. We sent Sean lines around the rim. They remain a coin being due an incomplete strike. That doesn't make any sense to me. Lines running through it. No. Raised lines on the inside rim of the pennies. All right. I don't know what to say here. Let me you know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna click on images. Yeah, I mean, they're showing die cracks. I'm not even going to show it to you unless they have the one I'm looking for. All right, so what we're going to do is, remember, what you have to do is, I'm keeping this one. Just because of that one little thing there. My feeling is that this is a something coin. Is that? Yeah, just because of that, I'm keeping it. But I'm going to put it in a flip. You know what I mean? Again, it's going to go from the bag into a flip. So if you know what the error is, like let's say you're like, oh, I know that error. It's a stutter strike, right? So I don't think this is a stutter strike, but let's say you thought it's a stutter strike. You have to put the timestamp in, okay? So you'll put 1535. Oh, that coin, that penny has a stutter strike error. But either way, that one's going to the left. And that's way, way, way too long. And I have to put up the... Okay. All right. So I have to move a little quicker through this. Again, we're going to be here forever. So this is an episode, by the way. This is episode 222. You got to be kidding. I mean, if every penny looks like this, I'm going to be here forever. Let me look at that. It's got to be post-mint damage. Yeah, I'm going to say it's post-mint damage because of the other things that are consistent with that. Like, you see that mark over here? So I'm going to say that's post-mint damage. Goodbye. And again, if I don't do some moving, I'm in big trouble. All right. All right, so this one just has damage on it. Goodbye. 1960. You know what? I'm going to have to pull the scale out because if something feels heavy, I'm going to need a weight or light. I want to weigh it. A 67 is nothing. Oh, okay. So I probably see up there, it's missing. That's from the crimp roll, I believe. Let me still weigh it. 315. I knew it was kind of heavy. It's not over tolerance, though, or under tolerance, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, that's from the crimp roll machine. Even though you don't see it or it's from something, but it's probably not a... It's pretty cool, though. I mean, but you can tell it's sliced off. You know, I'm not going to mess with it, man, because I'm just not. If you're going to say that's a $1,000 penny or something, then all right, well, go to the bank that I bring it to and you can have it. But these things have been in the bag forever. Misaligned die. So Woody, I'm not crazy about it, to be honest with you. I got so many of these. They have to be really, really nice. It's pretty cool. Forget it. I have boxes and box 63D. If there's any doubling on the obverse, it's a key variety. I wonder if I even knew it. I don't even think I was using a penny mat back then. Oh yeah, this is a double die. This is a valuable penny. So the ones that are 100% valuable, I'm gonna put right into a flip instantly, and I'm gonna mark it. So the U is doubled. So that's it. The U is doubled. I'm not even going to go crazy looking at all the other things that are doubled or not doubled or dirty or clean. The U is doubled. Straight up and down double. It's a 63D. So this is a key variety. Goes in the flip. And I'm not even gonna, what I'm not going to do is, you know what? Yeah. And I think I looked this one up the other day. But this one that we just found is better. So let's put 63 DDO. That's it. Oh, I put DD0. DD. Oh. Okay. 63 DDO. It's got to have a nice doubling. The U is really pretty nice doubled in my condition, in my opinion. All right. So the MS, so this is what we got. Yeah, mine's way better than that. That's $5. Yeah. 15 L on rim, that's BS. Yeah, I'm going to say it's about a $20, $30 penny. That's what I was thinking. So what I'll do is I'll just put the 63D DDO. I'll put $20 on it. And that's it. That's what I'm going to do. And that goes to the side. Okay. I wonder if I even, I probably didn't, like I said, I probably didn't even have a penny map back then. 86. See, I put this to the side. I can tell you already, I put this to the side because of the reflection, the toning. 61D. Nope. And see, I really have to look at this because not for nothing. If it's, you can see the ring, you can see the crimp roll around it. Went through the B. And the one, yeah, it's garbage. 68D. Because of that line there. Look how the line is on the inside, doesn't even touch the rim. And it's pretty cool. But no, I'm not keeping it. Oh, I see. Yeah, is it? If that's a strike through, I don't like it. It's too argumentable. Oh, that's a beauty. I put that into the AU. Okay, yeah, and I collect these two. I hold on to those. Misaligned die. Nah. That's the crimp roll. Well, it probably is the crimp roll. Yeah. I can't mess with that stuff, man. I don't have time for it to try to convince somebody. Yeah, that's valuable. Man, I can't do that, man. I ain't got time for it. But at the time when I was 66. DD on the obverse. Oh, okay. And it's funny that the one that it could be a key variety has all that gook on it. And the T's doubled. You're not going to believe this. The 66. Look at the T. The T's doubled. With all this gook on it. Let me see. I have an alcohol pad here. The only thing I really want to see is the, see if it comes off. I mean, if it's like hardcore glue, I don't know. I'm probably going to end up ruining the penny, having to clean it. Let me see. Huh? Yeah, it came off. It's coming off. So the gook is coming off. And alcohol doesn't change the patina or anything like that. Believe it or not, neither does turpentine or it's that aluminum copper cleaner that will really, that destroys the. So here you go. Is the T still doubled? Do I still think the T is doubled? Is that? Yeah. Same thing with that T. Oh, let's clean the Liberty. All I was just finished cleaning it. How about the reverse? I didn't even look at the reverse. Might as well clean that little dirt in the end right there. As long as I'm cleaning. Yeah, it came right off. See, that's why I like the outcourt pads. And that little piece of dirt came right out. And it doesn't change the patina. It would not grade as cleaned or anything like that. The only way any of these are going to get graded as cleaned is if you use that. You got to use something very, very toxic or, you know, has to show cleaning. All right, so this, what's this, a 66? Did I look it up already? No, it's a 63 I have up on there. And then I have a little, what's the little polishing cloth I got? Whatever, I'll take another one out. I had a bunch of them here. What I do is I buy everything in bulk. If you watch my previous videos, you'll see I bought a box of, I like using the nickel flips for the pennies. They hold it better. So I bought a box of like, I don't know, what 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, I think I bought them. All right, so 66 it is doubled. You can see it there, and the T is great. Both T's actually look pretty doubled to me. So we got doubling. So let's look for the 66 DDO. And see what comes up. Sold. Remember, this is sold. We gotta find a good one. Possible DDO. They want $15. Come on, man. Show me the picture. All right. Here goes one for $30. And I think mine is better than that, to be honest with you. That's the one where the W and the E is kind of slanted. So this one's better. I'm gonna put this. And again, you could disagree, whatever you want. I don't care. I'm gonna put this as better than that. Oh, hey, there's a $50 one. Here's a $50 one. I was gonna say $50. So that one's 50, and you see the little arrow there. 50. So I'm gonna put this as $50 penny. You could disagree. It might even be more, because honestly, I think this is better than any of the ones I've seen up to 50 points. All right, so let's put this in. See the nickel holders, how much better it holds it. The other one, you have to squeeze it in. It's such a pain in the butt. I can't stand those other, the penny flips. I really can't. And I only put one staple. DDO, $50. It could be 100, it could be 200. If I get it graded, I mean, it's in great condition. It's probably AU58, MS 62, something like that. So that's a $50 penny. Yeah, this is going to take forever. I might have to do this in parts. This is way, way, way. Yeah. See, this is probably a mint error. Look, the other sides. This was probably in a feeder, and it was going back and forth. That's why the bottom is clean. But, you know, you got to prove it, and I ain't got no time for that. All right, so what we're going to do is, oh, no, did I just, oh, no. Okay, yes, I don't want to mix the, I just went like this. I moved my hand, and I just moved it into the pile. Yeah, so we're going to, I'll do one more. 71S. Wow, you don't see that too often. The strike is weak. Yeah, I still don't think it has, oh, the S looks like it might have. Huh. Let me just make sure that's not a repunch mint mark. No, but the whole strike is weak. All right. Yeah. All right. So for the last penny for episode, what are we on? 222. But it's just too much, you know. Yeah, this is episode 222. So let's see what. I'll look up one more penny. And what is it? The 71S. And we're going to call it weak strike. I'll just put weak. Yeah, you know what? All the 71S's here, I'll show you. All the 71S's, not all, but you know, that to me, that looks pretty weak too. Maybe not as weak as the one I have. But look, in BU condition, they're $2. So, where's it at? Where's it at? There you go. So, you know, is it a 50 cent penny? You know, here, God bless. It's not going to the bank, but it's going inside the thing. I'm not keeping it. Okay. That was pretty cool. I'm sure it was, I did half the load, and, I'll do the other half in episode, 223. Yes. Episode. So, if you're a member, you'll get to see the, episode 223 right away. If not, then you'll have to stay tuned till tomorrow. Thank you. God bless. Jesus loves you. And I will see you in the next one.